how do you feel about this? When you look back on Michael Jordan, is he the guy, other than maybe Muhammad Ali, that deserves this type of treatment?
Well, let me say two things. First, about ESPN. What ESPN does is overhype. I mean, that's what they do. They, you know, when you and I were younger, and I hate to sound like that guy, but I genuinely thought that SportsCenter back in the 1990s was the greatest show in the history of television. I mean, I really thought it was that good when Dan Patrick and Keith Olbermann were doing it, and it is a shadow of that now, because there's one highlight and then there's 5 minutes of guys yelling at each other. And then another highlight, and then, you know, a round table discussion and a six pack of questions. But, you know, that being said,
was the six pack of questions, is that when ESPN jumped the shark?
It may have been, I don't know. I mean,
or Sean Salisbury.
You know, the yelling show that they have on now on ESPN2 in the mornings.
Which one?
With two loathsome people that I don't even like to name.
Yeah.
It's probably the worst sports show that I can even think of. And
it's like
they just
best
have
show.
two trolls sit up there and just make up stuff to piss people off.
But it's their most popular show, I'd imagine.
Well,
I mean, I'm just saying. I bet
there's no accounting for taste, I guess. It may very well be. I can't imagine why anybody would want to watch that. But anyway. But when there is something that is worthy of hype, ESPN does that better than anybody.
Yeah.
And Michael Jordan, like very few things in life, is worthy of the hype. You and I sort of were growing up as he was at the height of his powers.
Yeah.
I got to see him one time in person. It was against the Rockets, and I still remember it because he had about 15 points at the end of the third quarter, and the Rockets were ahead by about six. And he scored 18 points and had five assists in the fourth quarter and single-handedly took over the game. Wow. And I was sitting up in the rafters, and I couldn't even get mad because this was when the Rockets were good, when Akeem was there and Kenny Smith and some of the other great supporting cast, and he just took over the game. And I couldn't even get upset because it was just such an amazing performance. And you know, I don't really think you need a whole week for Jordan's 50th birthday, but I know that they're going to show his 50 greatest plays on February 17th, and you better believe I'm going to watch that because there's never been a basketball player that I've ever seen that did the things he did. And I was not a Michael Jordan fan because he went to North Carolina, and so I tried to hate him.
Double whammy.
Right. But, I can't think of an athlete since, I was really too young to remember, you know, Ali in his prime and even after his prime. And I think he's probably the most important athlete that's come along just for everything that he stood for and everything he did. But in terms of, you know, the greatest athlete in his or her particular sport, I think Jordan is it.
I think hands down, too.
I mean, I really think it's good that there's this kind of retrospective because he's been retired now, I don't know, almost 10 years, maybe?
Probably, yeah.
Seven, 8 years. And people, are starting to forget because you're starting to see these. LeBron is coming along, and then, you know, what about Kobe? Kobe's got five rings and all this crap. And I just think it's good to go back and remember that he was the best basketball player who's ever played. And it's stupid. You know, someday there will be a better player. I mean, it's inevitable that someday there will be, but it's not right now.